Hello everyone. So as we have completed all the theoretical part till now, and from today we'll be heading towards the practical part. So we can say that from today we'll be starting accountancy. So in the previous sessions we have learned the basic accounting terms such as assets, liabilities, purchases, sales, etc. Now we will learn its practical implication, starting with the basic accounting equation. So in today's session we'll be learning about the concept of accounting equation, how it works, its format, accounting equation based on basic transactions. So before understanding accounting equation, it is important to know about balance sheet. So as we know, balance sheet is prepared to know the financial position of the business. Here is the format of balance sheet, where on right hand sides assets are recorded and on left hand side capital and liabilities are recorded. Now what are assets? Anything which can be converted into cash is assets, or the benefit of which a company can get in future, that is assets. Assets kya hai? कोई भी ऐसी चीज जो इजीली कैश में कन्वर्ट हो जाए या फिर उसका बेनिफिट हमको फ्यूचर में हो, दैट इज असेट्स. एंड व्हाट इज कैपिटल? अमाउंट इन्वेस्टेड बाय द प्रोप्राइटर इन द बिजनेस इज कैपिटल. कोई भी बिजनेसमैन जो बिजनेस शुरू करता है, तो जिस अमाउंट से वो बिजनेस शुरू करता है, जो अमाउंट वो बिजनेस में इन्वेस्ट करता है, दैट इज नोन एज कैपिटल. एंड लाइबिलिटीज मीन्स फंड्स बोरोड बाय द बिजनेस फ्रॉम द outsiders. Your businessman kisi outsiders se funds borrow karta hai, that is liabilities. So in the balance sheet, both the asset sides and liabilities sides are always equal, because the assets of a business are purchased either from the funds, which means capital supplied by the proprietor, or from the funds provided by the external parties. So balance sheet mein hamesha assets aur liabilities ka column इक्वल होता है, क्योंकि जो बिजनेस के असेट्स हैं वो कहाँ से परचेज किए जाते हैं? या तो कैपिटल से, कैपिटल इज द अमाउंट इन्वेस्टेड बाय द प्रोप्राइटर, या फिर उस फंड से जो एक्सटर्नल पार्टी से बोरो किए गए हैं. सो इन दिस बैलेंस शीट देर आर टोटल असेट्स वर्थ रुपीज 1 लाख, आउट ऑफ विच असेट्स ऑफ 60,000 हैव बीन परचेज्ड फ्रॉम द कैपिटल प्रोवाइडेड बाय द प्रोप्राइटर, एंड द रिमेनिंग 40,000 these assets are purchased by the funds provided by external parties. So we can say balance sheet can be balanced when the assets and the liabilities are equal. So coming back to the topic accounting equation signifies that the assets of a business are always equal to the total of its liabilities and capital. Capital is also known as owner's equity. So in balance sheet we have already discussed that the liabilities and asset sides are always equal. So accounting equation is the same thing, where the assets of the business are always equal to the total of its liabilities and capital. Accounting equation is also based on the dual aspect concept. Dual aspect concept means every transaction has two aspects, debit and credit. We have studied this earlier, which means after every transaction, assets should be equal to the liabilities. कोई भी एक transaction किसी भी दो account को affect करती है, या फिर debit को और credit को. और हर transaction के बाद assets को किसके बराबर होना है? Liabilities के बराबर. So accounting equation can be expressed as assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. Now liabilities here is external liabilities. External liabilities means the amount which the business has to pay to the outsiders, that is known as external liabilities. And second is capital. So capital is an internal liabilities, which means it is the amount which the business has to pay to the proprietor or the owners. It is known as internal liabilities. So accounting equation is always expressed as asset is equal to liabilities plus capital. And the above equation can also be presented as asset minus liability is equal to capital, or asset minus capital is equal to liabilities. For example, in balance sheet also, this position can be expressed in the form of accounting equation as assets is equal to liabilities plus capital, where asset is 1 lakh, liability is 40,000 plus capital is 60,000. So now we will discuss the effect of transactions on accounting equation. Starting with the practical questions, first question is, suppose Gopal starts a new business and the following successive transactions take place. Gopal has started a new business and these are the following transactions. First transaction is, Gopal started business with rupees 75,000 as capital. So in this transaction, firm has received a total assets of 75,000 in the form of cash, and there is a liabilities against the firm also, that is 75,000 in the form of capital. So is transaction mein Gopal ne business shuru kiya hai 75,000 as capital. Sabse pehle accounting equation likhenge, assets is equal to liabilities plus capital. Gopal ne business shuru kiya hai cash se. So iska matlab hai Gopal business mein cash leke aa raha hai. So cash is a asset, it will be opened on asset side. Next is the liabilities. Here liabilities means external liabilities. So Gopal ne kisi outsider se paisa nahi liya hai. So there will be no amount on liabilities. Next is capital. So agar Gopal business mein 75,000 as a capital lekar aa raha hai, to wo business ke liye kya hai? Liabilities hai, internal liabilities, which the business has to pay to the businessman. So Gopal 75,000 as a capital lekar aa raha hai, to capital mein amount kitna ho jayega? 75,000. So the equation will be cash is equal to liabilities plus capital, where cash is 75,000 and capital amounts to 75,000. So assets is equal to liabilities. Next transaction is, Gopal purchased furniture for cash rupees 5,000. So in this transaction, two accounts are affected. First is furniture, second is cash, and both are assets. So according to the accounting equation, where assets is equal to liabilities plus capital, on assets side, cash was already opened, but a new column of furniture will be opened in this transaction because furniture is also an assets, and rest will be the remaining liabilities plus capital. Now according to the old equation, where cash was 75,000, no amount on furniture, no amount of liabilities, and capital was 75,000. So according to the new transaction, where Gopal purchased furniture for cash 5,000, in this transaction, cash is reduced by 5,000, but a new asset of the same amount has been acquired. So this transaction decreases one assets, and at the same time, it increases other assets with the same amount, leaving the total of the assets unchanged. So, is transaction ke according, jahan Gopal ne furniture purchase kiye cash mein 5,000 ke, to yahan pe do accounts effect ho rahe hain, furniture account and cash account, and both the accounts are assets. So furniture agar cash mein purchase kiye hain, iska matlab cash mein reduction aa raha hai, 5,000 ka cash mein furniture purchase kiye, so 5,000 will be deducted from cash. Wahi pe new asset same amount ka kharida hai, to naya asset bhi increase hua hai same amount se. To ek transaction kya kar raha hai, do accounts ko effect kar raha hai, ek bad raha hai aur dono same account hai asset side ke, to ek bad raha hai aur ek माइनस हो रहा है, डिक्रीज हो रहा है सेम अमाउंट से. तो यहाँ पे जो असेट का अमाउंट है वो एक तरफ से अनचेंज रहा है. सो न्यू इक्वेशन विल बी कैश अमाउंटिंग टू 70,000 एज 75,000 माइनस 5,000 इज 70,000, फर्नीचर इज 5,000, लाइबिलिटीज देर इज नो एक्सटर्नल लाइबिलिटीज, एंड कैपिटल इज अमाउंटेड टू 75,000. नेक्स्ट ट्रांजेक्शन इज, Gopal purchased goods for cash rupees 20,000. So in this transaction, two accounts are affected. First is goods, second is cash, and both the accounts are assets. So according to the accounting equation, where asset is equal to liabilities plus capital, a new column of goods will be added on asset sides. Now recording the old transaction, where cash was 70,000, furniture was 5,000, no goods, no amount of goods, no external liabilities, and capital was 75,000. Now, according to the new transaction, cash balance is reduced by 20,000, and the another asset, which is goods, has come into existence with the same amount, 20,000, leaving the total of assets unchanged. So goods purchase किए हैं cash में 20,000, so cash reduce हो रहा है और वहीं पे नया asset आ रहा है same amount का. So the new equation will be cash amounting to 50,000 as 70,000 minus 20,000 is 50,000. Furniture amounting to 5,000, goods amounting to 20,000, no amount on external liabilities, and the capital amounting to 75,000. Now the fourth transaction is Gopal purchased goods on credit for rupees 16,000. So in this transaction, two accounts are affected. First is goods and second is creditors. Creditors are the person from whom goods have been purchased on credit. So goods are assets and creditors are liabilities. So according to the accounting equation, where asset is equal to liabilities plus capital, there will be a new column of creditors will be opened on liabilities side. So old equation was cash was 50,000, furniture was 5,000, goods was 20,000, no amount of creditors, and the capital amounting to 75,000. So according to the new transaction, goods खरीदे हैं credit में 16,000. So goods खरीदे हैं यानी goods में increment हो रहा है, assets में increment हो रहा है 16,000 का. At the same side, liability अब credit में खरीदे हैं मतलब creditors भी बढ़ रहे हैं 16,000 से. So new equation will be cash amounting to 50,000, furniture amounting to 5,000, goods amounting to 36,000. Including 16,000 purchased on credit, so 20,000 plus 60,000 is 36,000. Creditors amounting to 16,000 and capital amounting to 75,000. Next transaction is goods costing 12,000 sold on credit for rupees 15,000. So when goods were purchased on credit, creditors column was opened, but when the goods are sold on credit, debtors column is opened. So 12,000 के goods 15,000 में बेचे हैं credit में. So there is a profit of 3,000 also. So according to accounting equation, where asset is equal to liabilities plus capital, old equation was cash amounting to 50,000, furniture 5,000, goods 36,000, no amount on debtors side, creditors 16,000 and capital 75,000. Now according to the new transaction, new asset in the form of debtors, which is amounting to 15,000. Now debtors are the person to whom goods have been sold on credit. We will be receiving this amount from the debtors in future. But the goods is reduced by 12,000, the cost of goods sold. So there is an increase in assets of rupees 3,000 in the form of profit, and it will be added to the capital. तो इस transaction में 12,000 के goods बिके हैं, इसका मतलब goods reduce हो रहे हैं, goods minus होंगे 12,000 से, debtors बढ़ रहे हैं क्योंकि credit में बेचा है, और जितना भी हमारे पास profit amount होता है, वो कहाँ add हो जाता है? Capital में. So the new equation will be cash amounting to 50,000, furniture amounting to 5,000, goods amounting to 24,000 as 36,000 minus 12,000 is 24,000. Debtors amounting to 15,000, creditors will be the same 16,000, and capital will be increased by 3,000 amounting to 78,000. Now the last transaction is paid rupees 1,000 for rent. Rent pay किया है 1,000 का cash में. So according to the accounting equation, where asset is equal to liabilities plus capital, old equation is cash amounting to 50,000, furniture 5,000, goods 24,000, debtors 15,000, creditors amounting to 16,000 and capital 78,000. Now, according to this transaction, there is a reduction of cash of rupees 1000 and also rent is an expense. So, it is a loss. Loss decreases the capital. That is why it is also deducted from capital. Rent pay kiya hai cash mein, to cash to jai raha hai, cash minus hoga. Aur rent kya hai? Rent loss consider kiya jata hai. Aur loss kahan se minus hota hai? Capital se. Agar profit capital mein add hota hai, to loss bhi capital se reduce hoga. So the new equation will be cash amounting to 49,000, where 50,000 minus 1,000 is 49,000. Furniture amounting to 5,000, goods 24,000, debtors 15,000. Creditors 16,000 and capital amounting to 77,000 as 78,000 minus 1,000 is 77,000. So this is the final equation of this question. Now if we add the asset sides and the liabilities side, we will see that the assets and the liabilities are equal. So we can say that accounting equation is true in all cases. Now here are some practice questions based on the topic discussed above. First question is, what is an accounting equation? Second question is, how accounting equation is expressed? Third is, give two basic purposes of accounting equation. Fourth question is, prepare accounting equation from the following. First transaction is, Sandeep started business with cash 1 lakh. Second, purchased furniture for cash 5,000. Third, purchased goods for cash 20,000. Fourth, purchased goods on credit 36,000. Fifth, paid for rent 700. And the last transaction is goods costing 40,000 sold at a profit of 8,000 for cash. So that's all for today. In the next session, we'll continue with some more practical questions. Thank you.